हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन पार्ट 3। अर्लियर वी डिस्कस द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन पार्ट 2, वेयर बाय वी डिस्कस द इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन्स विच वर डीसी मशीन्स एंड द सिंक्रोनस मशीन। टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन द थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर। अ थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर इज डिवाइडेड इंटू स्क्विरल केज इंडक्शन मोटर। In the squirrel cage induction motor, copper, brass or aluminium bars are placed at the as the rotor conductors, parallel or approximately parallel to the shaft and close to the rotor surface. The currents flow through the least resistive path, that is the rotor conductors. At both the ends of the rotor conductors are short circuited, as you can see in the figure, by continuous end rings of similar material as that of the conductors. The rotor conductors and end rings form a complete circuit that resembles a squirrel cage. Hence, the induction motor is called squirrel cage induction motor. Since the rotor winding is permanently short circuited in cage construction, so there is no possibility of adding any external resistance in the rotor circuit. The second type of three phase induction motor is the wound rotor induction motor. As the name implies, such a rotor is wound with an insulated winding similar to that of the stator. Since the connection of the wound secondary to the external terminals is done through slip rings and brushes, so wound secondary rotors are often called as slip ring induction motors. The slip ring induction motors are less extensively used compared to the squirrel cage induction motor because of their higher first cost and greater maintenance cost. Thus, slip ring induction motors are used only when speed control or higher starting torque is required, and this is due to the facility of adding external resistance in series with the slip ring. This is the cut section of both the types of three phase induction motors, that is the squirrel cage induction motor and the wound rotor induction motors. As you can see from the figure, the cut section shows the rotor. The rotors in both the three phase induction motors are completely different. You can see in the squirrel cage induction motor, the rotor is big and it forms a squirrel cage kind of structure. While in the second figure, in the wound rotor three phase induction motor, it is made up of slip rings. Now we'll be discussing on the single phase induction motor. The first type of single phase induction motor is the split phase motor. A single phase supply cannot produce a rotating magnetic field. Also, two windings connected in parallel to the single source only can produce an alternating magnetic field but not a rotating magnetic field. If, however, an impedance, that is resistance, inductance or capacitance, is connected in series with one of these windings, the current may differ in time phase, and if it is done properly, it may differ by 90 degrees, thereby creating a rotating magnetic field from a single phase supply. This is the principle of split phase induction motor, and the single phase motor classified according to this principle are: number 1, resistance start single phase induction motor. Every split phase induction motor has two windings, main winding and the auxiliary winding. The auxiliary winding is used for starting of the motor. Hence, as the name implies, in this type of motor, an extra resistance is added in series with the auxiliary winding. And hence, there is a phase split between two windings. And so it is called resistance start single phase induction motor. And after the motor acquired 75% speed, the centrifugal switch, as shown in the figure, opens. And the auxiliary winding is cut off from the main winding. The second type of single phase induction motor is the capacitor start single phase induction motor. So it is also called as capacitor start induction run motor. In this motor, construction is similar as the resistance start motor, except that the resistance is now replaced by a capacitor here. Hence, at starting, the split phase between main winding and auxiliary winding is 90 degrees. The capacitor start motor, like resistance start motor, has the starting winding disconnected by centrifugal switch as the motor picks up speed. The third type of the split phase induction motor is the Capacitor start. Capacitor run single phase induction motor. In this type of motor, two capacitors are used, CS and CR. That is starting capacitance and running capacitance. The CS is connected with the centrifugal switch and hence it is not a part of the circuit as soon as the motor picks up speed. But as the CR is still connected, so the motor is called capacitor start, capacitor run in the single phase induction motor. The fourth type of split phase induction motor is the permanent capacitor single phase induction motor. In this type of induction motor, the capacitor is permanently connected with the auxiliary winding and there is no centrifugal switch to separate it from the motor. So the motor is called permanent capacitor single phase induction motor. Another type of the single phase induction motor is the shaded pole motor. Shaded pole motor is a type of single phase induction motor in which the stator has salient poles, each provided with its own exciting coil. A part about 1/4 to 1/3 of each pole is wrapped by a copper strap, forming a closed loop known as shading coil, as shown in the figure. Arrangement is made such that the flux set up by the shaded pole lags behind the flux set up by the main pole and hence there is a split in phase, thus producing a rotating magnetic field even though the split in phase is not perfect 90 degree apart. Now we'll be discussing on the classification of transformers. Transformers are classified on a number of ways. The first one is on the basis of construction. The first one is the core type of transformer. In the core type transformer, as it is clearly visible, the winding encircles the core. The second type of transformer is the shell type of transformer. While in the shell type transformer, the core encircles the part of the windings or the coils. The coils or windings in the core type transformer can be easily removed from the maintenance point of view, but in the shell type transformer it is difficult because first the laminations of the core have to be removed. The second is on the basis of service in the field of power system. On the basis of service in the field of power system, transformers are classified into power transformers and distribution transformers. The first one is the power transformer. Power transformers are used in transmission network of higher voltages for step up and step down applications. Power transformers are used in transmission purposes at heavy loading, heavy voltage levels of more than 33 kV and 100% efficiency. Also, it is in larger in size. We see power transformers in generating station and transmission substation as shown in the figure. As power transformers are not directly connected to the consumer, there are no fluctuations in load and they are fully loaded during 24 hours a day. The second type of transformer is the distribution transformer. Distribution transformers are used for lower voltage distribution as a means to provide user connectivity. The transformer that we use near our house. It is used for the distribution of electrical energy at low voltage as less than 33 kV for industrial loads and 450 volt to 220 volt in domestic loads, and efficiency is 50 to 70%, and so they are smaller in size. As distribution transformers are directly connected to the consumers, so load fluctuations are very high. Thank you very much, friends. Now our next lecture will be on DC generators. Please like and subscribe our channel and stay connected for our future lectures.